the Earth over 65 million years ago, and now dinosaurs are back.
Are they on television still?
Yeah. No, they're in management positions, Kerri-Anne. No, they're back at the box office, and Jurassic World took home $1.3 billion, proof that even fossils still have it.
Just ask Donna Goldman.
Some fossils as well. In fact, there's
so many puns. So many puns. Scott Tweedie sat down with the people behind the hit film in New York for this Australian TV exclusive.
So, what are you dating, like an accountant now? Or...
Owen.
Ventriloquist?
Stop it.
You love a dummy.
This is not why we're here. You can blame me.
Try to shame me. I know why we're here. A rescue op. Save the dinosaurs from the island that's about to explode. What could go wrong?
Congratulations on such a... It's bizarre coming in here. Usually we talk before the film comes out. Now it's been out and absolutely smashed it around the world.
Thank you.
How did the fans react to the differences in Claire from the first movie to the second movie?
It's really like a real about face. Like, she really changed.
Do you remember the first time you saw a dinosaur? First time you see them, it's like a miracle.
Claire goes through quite a significant evolution from the first film to the second movie. I mean, the first one, she's top of the food chain, making choices that affect the bottom line rather than factoring in the potential ethical consequences that could come of these choices.
We have our first genetically modified hybrid.
And then in this movie, she's taking personal responsibility and she's become an activist and she is doing whatever she can to ensure that these animals receive the same protections as any other endangered species. I can't reach.
You're gonna have to climb up there.
Oh, I'm not. No, I'm not gonna climb up there.
You'll be okay. It's like riding a bull.
Riding a bull? I didn't grow up in a rodeo or wherever you came from.
Run! Run!
Do you, in the pre-production, have a meeting just on how much we can scare the audience?
Yeah, when we talk about the script and we always try to build up the tension, you know, to make the scenes the most effective possible. And then you need to figure out when are the best moments to jump, to do like scare jumps, the best moments to create suspense. You work on that to make it very specific in order to make it work on the set.
Maisie, stay down!
Now, it must be really tough to work with the cast and the crew that you had there, Chris Pratt in particular. Yeah, he's a very serious person.
No, I was so lucky that we had an amazing cast, not only Chris and Bryce, but we had, of course, Jeff Goldblum and B.D. Wong, but then we had Geraldine Chaplin, James Cromwell, Toby Jones. It was a dream cast. And, of course, working with Chris and Bryce. It's a lot of fun.
I've got one really long chest hair. I think we've established that. She's always on the hunt for it. Gross.
What's it like having one Chris Pratt on set? Could you imagine having two Chris Pratts on set?
Two Chris Pratts on set would be double the fun. It would be fun.
What is a day like working with him? Is it hard to get things done?
No, it's so good. It's like he's someone who has a really, really, really good balance in his life between work and play.
So I'll do the thing where my foot gets touched by lava, and that's what motivates me to get the role.
Yeah. He's someone who knows how to celebrate others, how to have a good time, how to create memories, how to enjoy his life. And then he's also someone who really, really, really knows how to work very hard, stay focused, get the job done.
I'm the focus.
What would he say about you and going with your laugh? You have one of the world's best laughs, I reckon. And if he's just throwing out jokes left, right, and center.
Oh yeah, it's nonstop.
You just be revving him along.
Yeah, no, we're a perfect team in that regard because I love to cackle and he loves to make people cackle. So it definitely works.
You had to die in the Jurassic World.
Yes.
How would you want to die? This is a terrible bad question, but how would you want to die?
If I'm answering that in a real way, because I hope that my character doesn't die, I hope that it's at least an ambiguous death, where you're like, you don't see the body, you know? Like a bit of a Sam Jackson death in like a la like Jurassic Park, where you're like, okay, so he doesn't have an arm.
Oh, Mr. Arnold.
But maybe did he survive a little bit? Yeah, either that or like something so traumatizing that kids are gonna remember it forever.
Blue!
If I don't make it back, remember you're the one who made me come here. I'll be all right. These creatures were here before us. And if we're not careful, they're gonna be here after. Welcome to Jurassic World.